bombshell, Comey just did it. Trump is absolutely speechless. Obama got caught red-handed by Al Weissman for freedomdaily.com. Former FBI Director James Comey just gave all of us law-abiding American gun owners an awesome Christmas gift. We all know how former President Barack Hussein Obama and his loyal sheep, such as Senator Dianne Feinstein, who is a CC permit holder herself, keeps regurgitating the myth that getting your hands on a gun in this country is so damn easy. While all of us legal gun owners know this is absolutely not true. In fact, it's quite the opposite. We have to jump through burning hoops and walls bigger than the future U.S.-Mexico border wall if we want to add another firearm to our arsenals. They tell us terrorists, criminals, and other people with severe mental issues can just stroll into your friendly neighborhood gun store and buy any high-capacity firearm, and there is nothing anyone can do about it. But in an odd turn of events, the now-embattled Democrat-friendly FBI Director James Comey just told the world that Barack Hussein Obama and his drones are full of it when they start up with the anti-gun narrative pushed by globalists like George Soros, who is funding the disarmament of the United States citizens in order to make his objective of a one world government a reality. Comey was asked point blank to give his facts about the gun issue, and what he had to say has shown the world us right-wingers were correct about Obama all along. If anyone ever says that America has no control over gun sales, just show them this. Via Kane TV, Comey denying gun sales to those on watch list could blow FBI terror investigations. And by the way, Obama's lying. The FBI is alerted every time someone on the watch list tries to buy a gun and can often stop the purchase. Democrats and the media would have you believe that when someone on the FBI's terror watch list tries to buy a gun, law enforcement officials are helpless and impotent. The suspected terrorist just walks out of the gun shop with an assault rifle and no one knows or can lift a finger in response to it. In testimony before the Senate on Wednesday, FBI Director James Comey explains this is far from the truth. Last week, our president stated that there are individuals who can't get on planes, but they can go to a gun shop and buy a firearm there, and he said nothing we can do to stop them, but, and correct me if I'm wrong, the FBI is notified when someone on the terrorist watch list attempts to purchase a firearm, and a NICS, National Instant Criminal Background Check System, check is requested, and the FBI has multiple avenues that they can pursue. Grassley said at the committee's hearing on the oversight of the FBI. These are some of these avenues. Delay the firearms transaction, and if the person is actually a terrorist, the FBI can arrest them for any crime for which there is probable cause. And in addition, the FBI can intervene and directly confront the individual. The FBI can also put the suspect on what's called around-the-clock surveillance. My question, aren't these some of the tools available to the FBI to stop a suspected terrorist from buying a gun? Grassley asked. Mr. Chairman, you're right, said Comey. There are a variety of things that we can do when we are notified that someone on our known or suspected terrorist database is attempting to buy a firearm. The FBI is alerted when that is triggered, and then we do investigate. Are these their disqualifiers that we're aware of that could stop the transaction? And if the transaction goes through, the agents who are assigned to the case to that subject are alerted so they can investigate, Comey added. Anyway, thank you very much for that clarification, said Grassley. So there are then actually many things that can be done right now to stop someone on the no-fly list from buying a gun. And that leads me to say that our president is misrepresenting the facts and misleading the American people on that point. Comey also expressed another concern about the idea being pushed very hard by Hillary Clinton that anyone on a watch list should be automatically denied their Second Amendment rights. In some cases, Comey said the FBI would prefer that the subject not be aware he or she is under investigation, and denying the gun purchase on the spot would have the potential to blow said investigation. Obviously, that's a judgment call that would have to be assessed on a case-by-case basis, but it's a perfect example of why you don't let politicians make such all-encompassing rules for law enforcement based on the emotion of the moment, especially in the aftermath of a horrible crime that sees people clamoring for the government to do something, even though many of those clamoring don't really have a solid understanding of what should be done or of what's really already being done. And Grassley is right that Obama is just flat out lying to the American public about this. As Comey explains, the FBI can take a variety of actions when it's alerted about an attempted gun purchase, and in many cases the purchase can be stopped, but that involves both due process and the need for judgment to be exercised about whether such an action is wise given the parameters of a larger investigation that might need to be protected. Would Obama and Hillary really want to jeopardize terror investigations in order to advance their gun control agenda? Actually, I don't really think that's such a hard question. Do you? To sum this up for you, there already is a law in the books that is meant to stop suspected terrorists from being able to purchase a firearm. So this would mean there is no need for more gun control for law-abiding firearm owners. This proves beyond any shadow of a doubt that the real aim the Democratic Party and their globalist friends have when it comes to firearms is a total and complete ban and confiscation. But I am sure they and their security teams will have exemptions. Please share if you want Obama to go away already. Oh, we've been saying that for a long time. Anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.